What is going on, guys? We are doing another Jeep video today. I showed in one of my last videos that I have light pods in the back of my Jeep. I'll show that again right now. Those are from a company by the name of Mohawk Off-Road Fabrication. He's a pretty active guy on some of the KL, which is the chassis name, or it's what the chassis goes by on those Cherokees. So he's pretty active on the KL pages, and I have bought a couple of his things, as you saw already. I do have one more that I bought from him, and it is a front light bar mount. This thing is pretty neat. He did a really good job with this. Let's take a look at it. He does all of his cutting in-house. He puts his logo there, so Mohawk Off-Road Fabrication. It's a really nice piece. He does a good job on it. If we're lucky, I might be able to con him into making a few pieces for the Rambler. I think he can only cut up to like a quarter of an inch. So I do have some things that I need for the Rambler for just some projects that you guys will see here soon. So I might be able to con him into that, and you'll see more of his stuff on the channel. But let's take a look at getting this installed. It should be pretty easy. It's held on by two C-clamps. A good start would be finding where I actually put those C-clamps, so we'll do that, and then we'll look at installing this, and we'll show you guys how it looks on the vehicle. Alright guys, so before I open the garage and let in some wind noise, here are the C-clamps that we use. So I believe they go in something like that based on the picture. I'm going to have to take a look. All they're doing is clamping this onto a piece that is behind the grill. So we're going to take a look. I'm going to get this installed, and then I'll show you guys how I mounted it. Alright, so before we get too far, I did have to change the bracket up here. I just had the configuration wrong. Nothing wrong with the bracket itself. Looking down in the car, you should see the logo there. And then the side configuration, to give you an idea, should look like that. So it pushes, the way the grill is angled, it goes back, the bottom of the grill kind of goes back towards the back of the car. So the light bar needs to be further back than the top of the mount. So you guys will see what I mean once I get this mounted in there. I'm going to try and mount it once again. So take a look down in there. You see, I don't know if you can see, you can see the logo there, the Mohawk Off-Road Fabrication. You can see where the C-clamps are in there. You could really put these C-clamps on the other way. This is just the method I did because it was easier and it pinched it well enough. This thing is not going anywhere, so you can see that one as well. They're at an angle. It's not the perfect way to do it, but it does work for me. I routed my power line up through a little gap in the plastic here, and it's up through here. I still have to run it to a switch. That is that. Let's take a step back and take a look at how it looks from up front. And it looks pretty good under there. I do not have this wired up yet, but you get an idea of how it looks. So we'll make our way around to the back too and take a look at the back pods that he makes. So there they are. I just have little pods on there. You could obviously fit something a little bigger if you wanted, but his setup is really nice. I mean, he has the grommets and everything himself. It just goes right into the license plate behind the license plate there. So just back up and take a look at it. So I'm a big fan of his work. He does a great job. Again, his company is Mohawk Off-Road Fabrication. I will put his link in the description to both his I don't know if he has an online site. I bought him on eBay, but I'll do his online site, his eBay, and his Facebook page if I can find all those. And yeah, that's it. Really nice pieces. Mike's a great guy. He, like I said, might be making some stuff for the Rambler for me here in the future as well. So that's about it, guys. If you guys want a light bar up front that's kind of discreet, and then the pods in the back, I would definitely check them out.